Alrighty, so once again, we have another actor who's claiming that the Oscars are racist. They're not just racist, that they're guilty of misogyny, and not just any misogyny, a special kind of misogyny that we're going to be finding out over the course of this video. Teal actress calls out Oscars for misogynoir after Best Actress. No, just like me, I'm pretty sure many of you are wondering, what the hell does that mean? Is it not just good enough to call it misogyny? It feels like a French word of something that you might order at a restaurant. Could you please give me a bottle of Dom Perignon with a touch of misogynoir? No? Yes? Anyways, let's get straight into this story. I'm going to share my opinion because she had a lot to say about the Oscars that I want to talk about. And it seems like, once again, I'm going to be playing the devil's advocate for the Oscars, even though I hate to do so. But I must say, it is very essential that I do so in this matter. Now, actress Danielle Deadwater says racism and misogyny played a role in the Oscar snub after the 40-year-old was passed over for her Best Actress Academy Award nomination. 40-year-old. God damn, this girl is looking good for 40. I guarantee you, 40 years is the new 30. Oh my damn. Anyways, Deadwater performed as Mamie Teal Mobley in Teal, a 2022 drama that depicts a mother's pursuit of justice after the lynching of her son, 14-year-old Emmett Till, in Mississippi. Now, I've seen this movie and I can tell you guys that this movie is very, 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 very good movie. It's a very, very good movie, and she had a pretty good performance as well. He goes on to say, we're talking about people who perhaps chose not to see the film. We're talking about misogynoir. You're talking about the fans, because once again, they happen to be attacking the fans, forgetting that some of the fans that we're talking about here are black. 13% of Americans are black. These black people are in the millions. We are talking about tens of millions. Many of them didn't go see your movie. So are they part of the people who are guilty of misogynoir as well? Like, it comes in all kinds of ways, whether it's direct or indirect, she said on an episode of the podcast, Kimode and Mayo's Take. It impacts who we are. No, it doesn't. It only impacts those people who are woke in the head, who've been brainwashed with all of this victimization mentality. It doesn't impact everybody else. It doesn't impact all black people. I guarantee you that. Misogyny, a term coined by black feminist author, the activist Mayo Bailey in 2008, refers to misogyny and prejudice directed at black women. Now, my question is this. This woman who coined this word, Mayo Bailey, she is a professor at a university. Should activists be professors at universities? Because they will be steering people's mind towards a certain direction rather than actually teaching people and let them come to their own conclusion. In other words, they will be teaching people what to think instead of how to think. It's just a food for thought. Her comments come after Teal director Chinonye Chukwu accused the Oscars, as well as the entertainment industry, of being aggressively committed to upholding whiteness after she wasn't nominated for Best Director role. Of course, this is towing the same line that Viola Davis did when her movie The Woman King wasn't nominated for anything at this Oscars, even though this woman has won an Oscar herself and has won an Oscar or an award in every other award show that you can think of. She's an EGOT. Regardless of that, she is still claiming that the Oscars, who gave her an award in 2017, are racist, regardless of the fact that they've given her and many other women awards. Now, Chinonye Chukwu, who is the director of the movie Teal, continued saying, we live in a world and work in an industry that are so aggressively committed to upholding whiteness and perpetrating unabashed misogyny towards black women. That's exactly what misogynoir means. Unabashed misogyny towards black women. So we learn something new every day. And yet, I'm forever in gratitude to the greatest lesson of my life. Regardless of the challenges or obstacles, I will always have the power to cultivate my own joy. And it's the joy that will continue to be one of my greatest forms of resistance. Chukwu wrote in an Instagram account in late January. Now, my question is this. If you know that these people are committed to upholding whiteness, why do you continue to work for them? And why do you continue to expect them to give you an award if you already expect that that's what they are? Well, maybe you don't truly think that that's what they are, but you're just claiming that as a form of some kind of marketing. Because when you take a look at this movie, Teal, if you take a look at the numbers, the last time I did a story about this particular movie, well, the numbers were about $9.9 million. However, since they've been making a lot of noise about this, a lot of articles have been written about this movie and so on and so forth. In the last 1 week, that number has jumped from $9 million to $10.3 million. So a couple of hundred thousand dollars sales in the last week. Pretty good for a movie that is no longer at the theaters. This is something they should have done before they released this movie way back in October. Rather, they're doing it after because they simply thought that if we push this movie out and because of what it's all about, people will simply just go and watch it. But people cannot watch what they do not know is existing in the first instance. If they had as much marketing, half as much marketing as The Woman King had, I think this movie would have done a lot more. Which brings me to why the Oscars probably didn't nominate this movie, because it wasn't impactful in the society, regardless of the fact that it was good. Now, when it comes to the actress herself, how great was the performance? From what I saw, I think there have been better actresses out there or actors out there that have had better performances in movies that never got nominated, and they never claimed that the Oscars were racist. Raja P. Hansen, a woman whose story is highly powerful and motivational because she beat all the odds that people told her that she would never make it because she's a black woman going to Hollywood at the age of 26 with a 5-year-old, that she would never make it. Today she's a household name because she didn't pay attention to all those victimization causes and all those infinity stone of wokeness. They tell you that if you have it, you're oppressed. She never paid attention to it. She had a blistering performance in Hidden Figures in 2016 or 2015 or thereabouts, yet she didn't win an Oscar award or nomination, even though she won NAACP awards, she won a Critics Award, Movie Critics Award, and some other awards here and there for that movie. She didn't claim that it was due to racism. She just accepted the fact that there might be some people who were in a better movie than hers, or there might be some people who performed better than she did, and that's that. Move on. That's life, you know? But these people continue to claim these things, yet you never ask yourself, why do they still continue to work for these people? Because the underlying thing is this: they care more about money than this activism. And this activism that they're doing, to me, is highly fake, but it is detrimental to the people that they push these things to, who buy into this wokeness mentality, which is highly, highly detrimental to those people. And at this point, the more these people keep claiming this is racist, that is racist, this is racist, they become to sound more and more like the boy who cried wolf. Because at some point in time, since everything is racist, nothing will be, because nobody will give a shiznit at the end of the day. And if we are really going to be putting things into perspective, the Oscars decided to adopt this idea of pandering to woke mob, because in 2016 they were accused of being so white. So as a result, they put things in place to make sure that they prioritize woke movies over prioritizing good storytelling and true storytelling. And this has been off-putting to a whole lot of people. So when people see movies like this that aren't exactly woke but are factually correct and historically correct, people will assume that they are woke and just simply disregard them. So at the end of the day, they pander to woke revolutionaries like these people, and even though they didn't make a woke movie, they are suffering from the narrative that they have been pushing. Hollywood has helped them push for this time. So at the end of the day, when it comes to this, I don't think the Oscars are racist. I simply believe that they are the victims of their own narratives.